nigga for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my fate, cause these eyes ain't got nothing on them.
What the fuck?
City, the scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel.
Yo.
These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle with the Baltimore Ravens.
Justin Tucker to kick off.
Justin Tucker all set, and we are set to see the cream of the crop in the AFC as we are underway here with the Ravens and the Chiefs. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25.
First and 10, here's Mahomes, eluding the pressure right. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he takes it all the way down to the 32. A huge play there right off the bat, 43 yards.
32-yard line.
Now a pass that's taken in by Hill. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
10 yards on the pickup. It's second and inches.
They'll run for the first time with Clyde Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 19.
Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes.
What? He's supposed to be tagged.
Coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
City Chiefs. First and goal at the 5-yard line.
Working from the gun, Mahomes flushed out right. This will be caught at about the 5. A lot of work to get away and outside of the pocket, but no actual yardage there on the catch. It's second down.
Yeah. He passed it. He ain't got no way to pass it, though.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Hammering for the goal line. He loses
the bucket. Get up.
And a big turnover there as these guys will get the football back.
No quit. Bitch, you quit because you fumble? What the fucking bitch ass nigga, yo? What the fuck type of bitch ass? God, why you make these bitch ass niggas, man? For real, yo? This nigga quit because he fumble? Hell, you fumble, bitch. It happened. It's part of the fucking game. Bitch, don't ever think you're going to beat me, nigga. Fake ass Mr. Perfect ass niggas. Oh, man. That shit nasty as fuck. Watery ass fucking drink. Can't believe it. No fucking body. No nobody wanna fucking play. What the fuck y'all be doing? Hey, yo, turn that shit off, bitch. I'm gonna blow you out. I know you being a Green Bay Packers too, nigga. I know you the pack. Yo, who the fuck is this nigga? Yo, you the new nigga?
Coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football and Big D as their guys will do battle with the Baltimore Ravens. Justin Tucker set to boom this one away, and we are underway from AT&T Stadium.
Like, you got to do something. We ain't playing nobody but Dallas. You tell me. Dallas. Like, who the fuck plays with Dallas? Hey, you're a Cowboys, you're a Cowgirl fan? You bum ass nigga. Yeah, nigga. I know you got a mic.
They'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play.
I know you running the ball, too. Since you're running the ball, we're going to blitz that ass.
Play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. He'll buy some time right. And his first pass is incomplete.
So many times we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver.
Real.
But a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
And
always spins past him into space. Elliott is well up. Field across the 45. 23 yards the pick up there.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan
the
field.
Boy.
And here he finds the open.
He ran the ball. Right.
Nice pickup.
Man, I don't want to hit none of that shit you talking about.
First down, Prescott. He finds his target. It's Schultz. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
Ran a perfect defense.
I don't like
situation.
How this thing's playing.
That
playing like a bitch.
Would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is. And they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Well, that last completion, certainly not what they were hoping for, as now they'll try to convert on third. Prescott now from the 50. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Derek Wolfe popping in for the sack.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. And look at this. They're keeping the punter on the sideline. They're going to go for it here on the opening drive. They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott. He rifles one that's intercepted.
Give me that.
Picked off by Devontae Harris. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line.
Nah, fuck that cool shit.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47.
First play touchdown. This is my ex-girlfriend.
After the interception, here's Jackson. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away.
And incomplete. Crisis averted.
Hey, what the fuck did I just say? Almost
picked. Instead, second down.
Brings up second and 10.
Jackson fakes the give and keeps it. An option handoff here to Dobbins. Uh-oh. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And down to the 29-yard line. 23 yards the pickup there.
I know that play went to the left side, and that's what it was designed to do, an outside handoff there. But how about the whole offensive line being involved? Seal the left side where the play was going, what they call play side. But how about on the back side? Just taking care of business to make sure no one can get there and disrupt it.
Is the biggest key the left tackle?
Without a doubt. Control that edge. Get out there. You want the left tackle, if you bring your tight end over there. Either way, control the edge of the line of scrimmage, you got a chance to rumble.
At the 28-yard line.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Like, fucking control in my way. Right,
from the gun, it's Jackson. And that'll be incomplete. Couldn't hang on third down. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9.
Oops.
And that'll be complete to Dobbins. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 10 yards there, good enough for a Raven first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
They'll roll him out right. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. They'll run with Dobbins.
Yeah.
He gets it a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. Second and goal from inside the 5. Jackson from the shotgun.
What the fuck?
And he's going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line.
This is a dummy.
A big play for Dobbins.
This is a real dummy right here.
Let's see where they turn on third and goal from the 5. This Cowboy defense looked ready for that third down pass. Brings up fourth. Fourth down and goal.
At
the 5-yard line. Well, they're going to try this. They need 5 full yards to hit the end zone here on fourth and goal, but they're going for it.
This is my little dummy right here.
From the gun, Jackson.
Yo, what the fuck?
And they're gonna get to him, a sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. No score after one on EA Sports.
Hey, what the fuck, you save me blood? Speak English, nigga.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Well, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is?
Interception.
It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
Looking to throw again on second down. Prescott, he'll fire deep. He's got a man complete. And all the way down to 37. Target Prescott to Cooper. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. They'll throw again. Prescott. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Amari Cooper, 28 yards, as his guys are first out of the scoreboard here this afternoon. Correct me if I'm wrong, that was just
a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down, Pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
This taken in about 4 yards deep.
What the fuck?
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charlie. It got his man complete. Past the 20, 10, and all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Hollywood, Marquise Brown, 83 yards. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2.
Ties the game at 7.
And how about this decision? Tie game, first half, but here's an onside kick. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. A second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
Being chased out left. Now he'll go deep down the middle. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. It's a gain of 35.
At that 8-yard line.
The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Prescott to throw it. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. Call it no gain there on the first down play.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get into him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. About 5 down to the 4-yard line.
Ezekiel,
a big play to start the drive got him in this position, but this defense has held firm since, and now it's 3rd and goal.
Brings up 3rd and
goal. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, and Jonathan Coachman will have, and he will take it in for a Cowboys score. Taking it in from 4 yards out, and the Cowboys have taken the lead. CD for them. This has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Take it off a little bit. I don't care what you're doing.
Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zerline. He'll kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
At their own 18-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
If I can hang
that's
up
exactly
from
how you want to draw things up. Whether it's
if I can hang up for
right
sure.
In your play
what?
One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here.
See if things can be
what?
We hear
I said that shit last night.
On second down, and he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete. Marquise Brown was the intended target, and that'll make it third down. Off the play fake to Dobbins, here's Jackson rolling to his right. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be out of bounds right around the 20. The decision to tuck and run gets him 3, but that's not enough. Now it's 4.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on 4th down and 9. side.
You mean today?
Now Jackson on first down, forced out to his left. He's going to take off with it. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
What'd you say?
A pair of first downs gives him a first and 10. I'm at the 44.
Yeah, I didn't hear what you said.
They go play action now. Jackson, he's going deep for Brown.
They'll catch the ball, bitch.
Incomplete. Hollywood Brown, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
Absolutely no disguise on that.
Hey, what you got, man? Speak of blood.
Put him out there and said, go deep. Let's try and hit him. Unfortunately, to no avail.
He ain't been using it, bro.
Jackson now on second and 10. Flush to his right. He'll run it.
You haven't been using your airbrush, right?
Jackson,
I already
such
did.
A threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Oh, that was dangerous. Jackson threw it into coverage, almost picked, but instead they'll keep it on second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Again on second and 10, it's Jackson. He'll find Dobbins out of the backfield. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
But it certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half,
what the fuck?
Will be intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. Not the best of plays here as a quarterback. You're right-handed, rolling long, trying to throw it that far downfield.
Coaching mind saying, son, that's the equivalent of trying to get the car keys out of your pocket with your opposite hand while you're trying to run. You just can't do it.
He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And lucky to get away with one there. That one nearly picked. Second down.
But no kneeling for them. They decided they weren't going to run out the clock. They decided to take their shot downfield, hoping to either make a connection or a pass interference call. They wanted more points to put on the board.
They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. Letting one fly deep for Cooper.
Come on,
and this
yo.
One
pick
incomplete.
The ball.
Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Patrick Queen. And he's given his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive.
Come on!
The Notre Dame man, Jalen Smith, able to get a hand in and knock it away. Complete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. On the option, it goes to Ingram. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four. Jackson on the give to Dobbins, and he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half.
Justin Tucker on for the field goal, a 26-yard attempt.
And Tucker, the former Longhorn, puts this one through. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3.
Greg Zuerlein to kick off for Dallas.
The Ravens set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action in the third quarter. get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys are tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. And he's going to have a Ravens first down as the tackle made it about the 43-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. Jackson's going to look to run it. Option play, and they'll hand to Dobbins. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 16 yards on that one at a Raven first.
Well, I can certainly tell my age, partner, because when I was a kid, running backs like J.K. Dobbins with over 2,000 yards in their final season in college, they went early in the draft. Instead, he somehow lasted until the second round. But how great is it to get a guy with that ability who can run it inside, run to the perimeter, and catch the football in the backfield? Be able to get him in the second round? That's what I call a steal.
Sean Lee, the linebacker, credited with bringing him down. And now Jackson will look to throw it. He's going deep for Brown.
Yo, what the fuck, yo? Throw the ball out there.
Picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And a good return as he's up close to the 40-yard line.
Fucking dollar, man.
The first half did not go their way, and that's not going to help matters at all. An interception here on the opening drive of the third quarter.
Should have launched that bitch. He burnt his ass.
But you know who's really upset on their team? The defense. Already trailing. They're going to be counted on to try and hold that score at least where it is.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally. You're my little dummy.
You're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game.
You're my little dummy.
How many things do we do at certain times? What
you're
are
my
our
little
tendencies?
Dummy.
Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try to create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions. And here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield. He was staying in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
First down marker at the 31. It's third down. A quick toss out right, and the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. Loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. Well, that was a heck of a play there on the outside.
Partner, sometimes I think on a play like this as a corner, you've got to think to yourself, all I got to do is slow him down so others can come over and support. But in this case, he said, forget that. I've got this. Sorry you had to make the run for nothing, fellas.
And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one as it's good from 56 yards out. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny when we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Set at the line for this next drive. They find themselves down 17-10 as they come up on a first and 10. He's going deep for Brown. And that's caught inside the 30.
Right down his throat.
serious, bro?
And they'll remain down by a point.
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off.
Fuck me.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. The best way to do it? Touchdowns.
Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, third and five.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
The Cowboys on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This will be third and five. Prescott. This to Jarwin. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
At the 40-yard line. Three-yard line.
I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
And the throw there going to be incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Comes the Cowboys punter, and surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. An excellent return that time, 26 yards, and the Ravens, they'll take over.
Their own 40-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20 from their own 40 to the other 40. The gain of 20 leads to first and 10. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Pass from Jackson, complete to Ingram. Call it a gain of five, and it'll be third down. This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Ingram. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive.
What?
Yeah. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And he's got it. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. Jackson on target to Brown for a Ravens first down. Back to throw. And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. Hollywood, Marquise Brown, there to make the grab. And the Ravens have retaken the lead.
And touchdown and congratulations and zero relaxation ahead of them, right? Way too much time on the clock for them to start celebrating.
Part one is done, but now on the sideline, you can already see them scrambling down there. They're getting those defensive guys ready.
Yes, you have to get those guys ready, and you also have to talk to your special teams guys. Make sure the kickoff is exactly what you want and cover it well.
And
a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now.
And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Calais Campbell finding his way home for the sack. He's back to throw. And this one quickly to Lamb. Now the Cowboys get a run the first down. Timeouts.
As they get the stop in this game, though.
50 seconds left to go in the game.
Down 3rd and 10.
Stronger,
and dominance is starting to take over, right?
Yeah,
the way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed
good
them out
we shut that shit down.
Performance down the stretch.
Okay. You gonna do it again? Okay. Again.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. With that, we say so long from Big D.
Hey, TDs for real, yeah. That shit crazy. That shit was unacceptable. yeah, I say unacceptable, yo. That shit was definitely unacceptable. Hey, where the fuck this nigga butt at, man? Nah, I don't give a fuck about that, boo. Let's run that shit. It's 9 o'clock. It's 7 o'clock, yeah. Shit. Look at me. Yeah, right.